This is a rare Belgian lithograph from 1895. It was removed from an old lining, re-linen-backed in pieces, and restored. See it today at Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Posterfix. I'm glad to have you back. Today we've got this enormous Belgian poster from the late 19th century. What's interesting about this poster is that it went through a lot. It was on an old archival linen backing, thank goodness for me. It made it easier to take off in that it would soak off in water. The thing is that it was already broken in the folds, and so I knew it would break coming off the backing, and that's how we approached the removal. And then we linen backed the poster in pieces and then did the paper fills and color restoration. You're going to see all that today. Watch. It's got a nice litho of a cow or an oxen. And the tools of building and farming. And I think that's what this exposition is about. Anyway, this is on an old paper backing, and the customer wants us to take it off this flimsy old paper backing. Oh, it's got thin canvas on it too. Thin, flimsy old canvas backing. Put it on a new linen backing and retouch it. It's probably ripped all along here. I can see there are numerous rips that are being held together by the old backing. There's also old touch-up in the reds, it looks like. This is also multi-sheeted. So we're gonna take this off this paper backing and linen back it.
Well, I've got the posters in here. This is a shallow bath. Pour water on top of it so that they can all soak. Okay, I've got the Belgian Exposition poster in this bath of water where it will soak for about 24 hours, and then tomorrow hopefully the backing will come right off. So I'll check back on this tomorrow.
You know, if you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, you can always drop me an email or give me a call. You can also consider bringing your posters by Posterfix in person and meeting with me so that I can go over them with you. If you want to do that, send me an email. Let me know what day and time you want to come over so I can shoot you over a security pass that will get you into Building 77 at the Brooklyn Navy Yard. I look forward to seeing your posters. If you prefer shipping your posters to me, please consider using UPS or FedEx as the preferred shipping method, as those carriers come right to my door. And in that case, be sure you also include a sheet showing your name, shipping address, phone number, and email inside the package with your posters. That'll help me when I get them to catalog them correctly in my books. I look forward to seeing your posters.
Ooh, 9 DeKalb Avenue is rising into the clouds.
The sections of this poster have been soaking for quite a while now, and we're ready to take out the pieces and remove the layers. The first layer to come off will be the canvas, and after that there'll be a layer of paper. Well, I couldn't find very much online about this poster or this exposition of 1895. Apparently, it's not a very major one, except that it has to do with cows. The society Sarlabot is concerned with this certain breed of cows called the Sarlabot, a breed invented in France in the mid-19th century. A man by the name of Dutron developed this cow. He wanted to breed a cow that was less prone to be violent, more passive, to avoid accidents.
Hi, Chris.
The cow became quite popular, and then it pretty much went extinct by the year 1900, so it existed for about half a century. Strangely, though, this breed is characterized as being an ox without horns. Well, the ox on this poster certainly does have horns, and they're big horns.
Okay, we've got this exposition poster taken off the old lining, and now it's drying, and then it will be rebacked after it's dry, after a few days. Well, we've got this exposition poster off its old backing, and we are ready to linen back it. I've just got to prepare a screen. Got this screen all ready. Now we can mount this exposition poster, which we will do after this commercial break, so don't go away. Well, we're back in the poster fix shop and we're about to mount this exposition poster from France onto this big massive screen that I've just prepared with acid-free paper and cotton canvas. See, I'm going to put this corner first, and I'm just sizing it up to see where it should be put. I think I'm going to bring it down here further more this way. You can see I've already drawn a line here to follow. So this is the first piece that's going to go down. I'm going to put the acid-free wheat paste right onto the paper. I think the paper is too fragile to have the paste put directly onto the paper, so. I'm spraying it with water to help it expand so it'll stretch out. Paper is porous and the pores need to fill and expand. Okay, it's time to linen back the next two-thirds of this exposition poster.
All right, this paper is more together. It's not falling apart as much as the previous one. The nice thing about this poster is that the paper absorbs the wheat paste very quickly and evenly, making it very agreeable when it expands, and while I roll it out, it flattens out nicely. These very old posters are really take well to being linen backed.
poster could talk, he would say, wouldn't that be?
An ox is a male bovine trained and used as a draft animal. Oxen are commonly castrated adult male cattle. Castration inhibits testosterone and aggression, which makes them more docile and safer to work with. Cows, or adult females, or bulls, intact males, may also be used in some areas. Oxen are used for plowing, for transport, pulling carts, hauling wagons, and even riding, or threshing grain by trampling, and for powering machines that grind grain or supply irrigation, among other purposes. Oxen may be also used to skid logs in forests, particularly in low impact, select cut logging. Oxen are usually yoked in pairs. Light work, such as carting household items on good roads, might require just one pair, while for heavier work, further pairs would be added as necessary. A team used for a heavy load over difficult ground might exceed 9 or 10 pairs. First been harnessed and put to work around the year 4000 BC. Working oxen are taught to respond to the signals of the teamster, bullocky, or ox driver. These signals are given by verbal command and body language, reinforced by a goad, whip, or a long pole, which also serves as a measure of length. See rod. In pre-industrial times, most teamsters were known for their loud voices and forthright language. Verbal commands for draft animals vary wildly throughout the world. In North America, the most common commands are back, which means back up, gee, which means turn to the right, get up, or giddy up, which means get thee up. I didn't know that. Or get ye up. Or go. Ha! Turn to the left. Ho! Stop. I think we've all heard these terms before. In the New England tradition, young castrated cattle selected for draft are known as working steers and are painstakingly trained from a young age. Their teamster makes or buys as many as a dozen yokes of different sizes for each animal as it grows. The steers are normally considered fully trained at the age of 4 and only then become known as oxen.
Well, we've got this exposition poster linen back and we're going to let it dry for a few days before we commence doing some paper fills and color touch-up, like in this area and in these areas here. So you will see all that after this commercial break, so don't go away.
Now we're getting into the home stretch. It's time to do the paper fills and color retouching. We're back in the Poster Fix shop and Oki is putting paper pulp into the areas along the edge which have missing paper.
Should I do here too?
Yeah. Well, no, maybe not. Maybe just burnish that well. So a few days have passed. My wife has done the paper fills now, as you saw, and I'm going to go in and touch up this poster today. I'm wetting these creases because I want to burnish them, and if I wet them, they will relax more and get nice and flat. This poster's got to get touched up, mostly just in these kind of areas here and here. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
These big French and Belgian exposition posters are always interesting to see.
Well, we're back in the poster fix shop, and this poster's got to get touched up, mostly just in these kind of areas here.
Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. I hope you enjoyed watching us restore this poster for the Belgian Exposition from the late 19th century. Again, like I said, if you have any questions about your posters getting restored, get in touch with me. Remember, at Poster Fix, we love to bring your vintage posters back to life.